What's up, YouTubers? Welcome to the video. And this is Diatone's new F7 or Roma F7, their 7-inch freestyle long-range quadcopter. Yeah, and you've seen the title of this video. In this video, I'm gonna review it and I'm gonna show you a tune for this quadcopter in short. In a little bit longer, I'll tell you what I like about this quadcopter. What I think this quadcopter is this long range again? Is this a high speed cruiser, a freestyle quadcopter? What kind of quadcopter is this? I'll give you the pros and cons of this quadcopter. Also, I'll tell you if I'll keep this quadcopter over my other 7-inch quadcopters. If you know me a little, I don't keep all my quadcopters around that I review, right? Otherwise I'd have a house filled with quadcopters. So again, is this quadcopter good enough to keep around? And the last thing I'll show you is the tune I ended up with for this quadcopter. So this is the Roma F7 from Diatone, and this is the Dutch RC channel. Here we go.
Serious?
Alrighty, first thing you've noticed is that I don't have the original bi-blades on the quadcopter anymore. I've got these HQ prop 3 blades. These are 7x3x3, I think. I'll have a link to these propellers in the description down below. Now, that doesn't mean that these propellers are bad. I simply prefer these. These suit my kind of flying better. Okay, so the first question you might have about this quadcopter is, what kind of quadcopter is this actually? I had actually thought that this would be a powerful freestyle quadcopter. And that might be my stupidity or whatever. Okay, so obviously 2808 motors, this is a powerful quadcopter. However, these motors are 1100 kV, and that makes it a different kind of quadcopter. This is more an efficient long-range quadcopter than a freestyle quadcopter, especially with these propellers. And that's what Diatone included these propellers with the quadcopter 4. With these propellers, it's a very efficient setup. I can easily, on this Lipo, an 1800 milliamp hour 6S, get flight times of 10 minutes with this quadcopter. So that's on the bi-blades, right? With these 3 blades, the flight time suffers, but you gain control. Okay, so again, with higher kV motors, like 1300 maybe, this would have been a proper freestyle powerful quadcopter. However, with these 1100 kV motors, it's more a high-speed cruiser, a long-range, long flight time cruiser, and that's fine. And yeah, again, that's why Diatone included these propellers with the quadcopter. So be aware of that. This is, again, not so much a powerful freestyle quadcopter, even though it can do freestyle maneuvers easily with these propellers. Yeah, but it's more geared towards long flight times and efficiency. Alrighty, alrighty, pros and cons. What is good and what is bad about this Roma F7 from Diatone? Let's start with the cons, the negatives, the things that I didn't like about this Roma F7. First thing, these propellers, they simply don't suit my kind of flying, freestyle flying, and at higher RPMs, so above 80 RPMs, that I get tip flutters or some kind of oscillation. I think it's tip flutter, and that's what you get into when freestyling a quadcopter, right? Not in high speed cruising, and yeah, that's what these propellers are obviously for then. There's no tuning against that tip flutter, making these propellers, for me, not ideal propellers for freestyle flying. That's why I moved to these HQ props. So with these propellers, it's solved, but again, that's a negative of the package you receive. These propellers I didn't like much. I'm not a long-range flyer, right? So if you are into long-range flights, these propellers will suit you better than they suited me. With a 7-inch quadcopter, you obviously run bigger lipos, right? Like this 1800 again. I'll have a link to this lipo as I tuned the quadcopter for this lipo as well. And with bigger lipos, the FPV antenna has a harder time sticking above that lipo, right? Especially if you were to long range cruise the quadcopter, you might run the quadcopter at a lower angle, a lower camera angle, and then especially that FPV antenna won't, will probably not poke above your lipo. Potentially the lipo will block your FPV signal. Now I haven't run into that problem, but it didn't fill me with confidence. This is the same antenna they use on their F5. I think it should have been like 2 centimeters longer. An inch, inch and a half, a little bit longer. Not hugely longer. I don't really like the enormous antennas I see on some long range quadcopters, but again, 2 centimeters would have been nice. I would have appreciated that. The propellers are, and that was to be expected, right, are very much in view. So this is the analog version. If you were to get this quadcopter in the digital version and were planning to use the onboard footage, so your DVR footage, the propellers are very, very much in view. As you can see here from my DVR, very much in view. Also, this is one of my tuning flights with the bi-blades. And as you can see, it flies great on the bi-blades, just as long as you don't get above like 70 or 80% throttle. Yeah, but it was very well tuned for. It actually flew very well on the bi-blades. Strangely well, actually. It was almost as if propforce oscillations was disabled in the simulator. Yeah, very nice. Just as long as you don't get above higher RPMs. Okay, so again, I have the analog version, and I've got the version that comes with, that would have come with an RXSR receiver or their own MSR receivers. Yeah, so F-port wasn't enabled. They run these receivers simply as S-bus receivers, and that means no telemetry. That's a shame, right? The MSR receiver, just like the RXSR receiver, is capable of telemetry. Why not use it? But yeah, I do understand they have to use a different setup for the flight controller. They simply use the same setup for, well, every receiver type, I guess. I'm not completely sure. It's a shame. They could have easily gone with an F-port implementation, and then you'd have telemetry. So that's a negative. And I think most or all Diatone quadcopters that come with FRSky compatible receivers have that issue, that shortcoming. And the last con I ran into with the quadcopter has to do with their 1 watt VTX, the Mamba Ultra 1000 milliwatt VTX. It works fine. It provides a good FPV image together with this Runcam Phoenix version 2. Nice camera, nice VTX. However, the VTX doesn't have a microphone, so you'll never have a sound in your goggle if you want to use that, or in your DVR recordings. So yeah, that's a shame. It's not an expensive VTX, this. And Diatomes in general are reasonably priced, but yeah, it would have been nice to have a microphone in that VTX. All right, surely there's positive things about this Diatone F7 as well. It is well built, as most Diatone quadcopters are, in my humble opinion. At least the one I received here was immaculate. All screws were tightened correctly, and nothing really weird. In some quadcopters I find that the stick screws are a little bit loose, or the grommets of the stick. Let me show you. These grommets give the stick a little bit too much leeway, possible movement. Even that was correct in the quadcopter. Very, very nice. There was nothing to... obviously I had to enter my settings, my rates, and that's about it, I think. I changed the OSD. Yeah, the OSD wasn't too to my liking, a little too busy. But the build and was perfect, basically. Also, I think this is a nice looking quadcopter. The color scheme is nice, especially with the original propellers, of course. Yeah, one thing that would have been nice is a blue FV antenna. I think Fox here has a teal blue FV antenna. But this is a nice looking quadcopter, in my humble opinion. I also think that the price is reasonable. Diatone quadcopters are generally reasonably priced for what you get. And yeah, all RC hobby products have become very expensive. But still, this is, for a 7-inch quadcopter from a brand name, an affordable quadcopter, in my humble opinion. I think it's worth what you pay in this case. Okay, I already mentioned that especially with the original propellers, this is a very efficient quadcopter. Far more efficient than my other 7-inch quadcopters. I've got two self-built 7-inch quadcopters, and those have 2806 motors. And I would have thought, well, 2808 motors, this quadcopter will be more amp hungry, but it's not. And again, especially with the original biblades, it is a the amp draw is low, and you get long flight times with this Diatone F7. You get great components. You get an F7 flight controller, F722 flight controller. You get a 65 amp 4-in-1 ESC. In fact, that same stack I used on a self-built quadcopter. And again, in general, you use higher priced components for self-built quadcopters. In this case, nice stack. A nice FPV camera, again the Roncam Phoenix version 2 works well, and a 1 watt VTX, very beefy motors, and even the GPS works on this quadcopter. Took approximately 3-4 minutes, that depends a little on the amount of interference you run into, but in general it works. And the second flight, if you do multiple flights at one spot, the second flight it'll take like 20 seconds, so great. And the last pro of this quadcopter, I found that on this low KV setup, it is very easy to fly smoothly. It doesn't feel as powerful. The initial bite, the amount of thrust in the first 25% of your throttle throw isn't huge, so it might feel a little underwhelming, but it does help you in flying smoothly, the resolution, if you will, in the first 50% of your throw, in your throttle throw, is better. So again, it's easier to fly smooth lines. If you want to capture nice footage with a quadcopter, this is a smooth setup. So yeah, very, very nice. It definitely makes for a cinematic quadcopter. Alrighty, and while I show you one other tuning flight here, this is a DVR recording of, again, one of my tuning flights. And keep in mind that I'm looking for trouble, as it were. Looking for propellers oscillation, for instance. There's very, very little in this flight, propellers oscillation. But again, have a look while I tell you whether I will keep this quadcopter or whether I'd buy it again, knowing what I know now. And I must say that this quadcopter is better than I had anticipated. In the past, especially, 7 and 6 inch quadcopters were hard to tune, were generally a little underwhelming. This one, however, is great. It is very efficient, as I told you. It is, however, not completely what I was expecting. I was hoping for a powerful freestyle quadcopter, where my two self-built 7-inch quadcopters are powerful freestyle quadcopters. This is simply a little bit of a different quadcopter, more endurance or long range. If I'd buy it again, I would definitely buy the DJI digital version. I think this quadcopter is worth the investment, the extra investment of a digital setup. It is, however, a little bit of a shame that this quadcopter, the 7-inch version, is only available with the Air unit, not with the Vista unit, where the 6-inch version is available with the Vista. If it's in stock, that is. Yeah, I prefer having this Roma F7 with the Vista unit. Of course, I can convert it to digital, right? It already has a flight controller ready for DJI. So yeah, very, very nice quadcopter. Better than I had expected. Alrighty, on with one of the important parts of this video for a lot of people, I think, the tune I ended up with for this quadcopter. So what you see here is the port tab. And I think nothing changed here. Yeah, nothing changed here. The ESC and flight controller combination is capable of ESC telemetry, so communication back and forth between the ESC and the flight controller, not needed, not used. And that's a thing of the past, basically, by now. I must add that I am on BetaFlight 4.3 and then release candidate 4. Yeah, so I updated the firmware on the flight controller, not needed. The PIDs, the PID tune I'll show you, will work with the stock BetaFlight that's on the quadcopter. 4.2.7 probably. Well, again, the BetaFlight version you get on the quadcopter, this tune will work for as well. With one exception, by the way, and I'll tell you what that exception is. All right, then the filters I ended up with. The gyro filter multiplier is pretty low, as you can see. And I had to do that because of the bi-blades. Now this tune, the tune I'll show you, is usable with the bi-blades and with the HQ props. See link in the description. On the HQ props you can get away with a higher gyro filter multiplier, like 0.95. But simply start out with what I show you here and then you'll have a safe setup. In fact, I did fly the quadcopter there with the HQ props with this exact tune. So a gyro low pass 1 I did enable. Generally I disable that, but again with those bi-blades I needed that filtering. So again, this is a safe setup. With these settings you'll end up with a well-behaved quadcopter, at least a good starting point. Then here are the bits I ended up with, and nothing out of the ordinary. I simply turned down the dampening and the tracking, as you can tell here, to 0.9. And if you don't want to use the sliders, you can obviously simply use the PIDs I ended up with here. And everything else is stock in this screen. You probably saw my maiden flights with the quadcopter and I had wobbles and flyaways. With the lower P's, I's and D's and the increased filtering, that was solved. But also by enabling bi-directional D-shot, which was disabled. I'm not sure why. I really don't know why. Again, ESC sensor is not needed, not really used anymore. Bidirectional D-shot, however, is kind of mandatory for this quadcopter. And in that case, you need to set the motor pulse to 14, probably stock for BetaFlight, but check that. And I increased the motor idle. Otherwise, I ended up with slight wobbles at zero throttle. So in upside down hang times and such, so you need a little higher idle speed. Not a whole lot, stock is 5.5, but I increased it a little. Then the last change I made was reducing the PID loop frequency. It was stock at 8, I set it to 4. However, that might be a BetaFlight 4.3 release candidate thing. I suspect that the release candidate has some bug tracking, debug code still in it, and the processor load is therefore a little higher. It was above 60% and I don't like it that to be above 60%. So yeah, I reduced the PID loop frequency. I could have also, I guess, disable telemetry, as telemetry isn't used like this, right, with this S-bus receiver. But yeah, if you want to use telemetry, again, with BetaFlight 4.3 release candidates, I ended up reducing the PID loop frequency. Probably, again, definitely not needed in the old stock BetaFlight 4.2.7. And if you run a real release of BetaFlight, it's probably also not needed. just check it. Hover the quadcopter at a pitch frequency of 8 and you'll see if the quadcopter takes off on its own. Alright guys, that's my review and tune for the Roma F7 from Diatone. And if you've made it this far, you are probably interested in this quadcopter, or maybe you have it. If you have this quadcopter, please let me know what you think of it in the comment section below. And also, if you have other questions, don't hesitate to ask. So, if you are considering this quadcopter, and maybe you are simply looking for a confirmation to actually get it, yeah, you should definitely shortlist this quadcopter. It's a great quadcopter, or just go ahead and buy it. You won't be disappointed. I think this is a very, very nice quadcopter. So, well done, Diatone. And this quadcopter does have me wondering whether I should try the F6. But yeah, probably, I think 6-inch quadcopters, I'm not sure. What do you think? Should I try the, it does look nice, but should I try the 6-inch quadcopter, the Roma F6 as well? Yeah, I really don't know. And it's also a costly quadcopter, as all quadcopters are these days, so yeah. Okay, so yeah, links in the description. Also share this video on your social media, thumbs up and comments, etc. You know the drill. Thank you very much for watching. Catch you on the next video. Bye bye.